NBC's Amanda Castro sat down with the lawmaker to get his thoughts ahead of this year's legislation.
Representative Dickey, 2015 legislative session coming up. What are some of the big topics you expect to tackle this year?
Well, transportation funding will be one. Always talking about education issues. Educational funding is an issue, and health care, especially rural health care in our rural parts of our state, and just health care funding and being able to pay for it will be a big issue as well.
When you say transportation, are you talking about, like, I know the 1675 interchange in Middle Georgia is a big topic, and
the funding going into our transportation budget is really shrinking due to people driving less and higher mileage vehicles. So, and the needs for our transportation road work is increasing. So the two lines are going in opposite directions, and we really, I think, need to start looking at ways to invest more money in our transportation infrastructure to try to alleviate the gridlock we have in many places and deteriorating roads.
And one thing I know Macon BIB leaders were talking about, taking another look at the consolidation charter, possibly reworking some of that the budget requirement to cut the budget. Is that something that state leaders
are concerned? We're going to talk about it. We were asked by the commission and the mayor, and we're looking at it. We will do some adjusting, I feel like, for that. But I'm not sure we're going to be willing to do all that they ask. Payne City is going to be another issue. I hope Representative Beverly takes a hard look at that. So yes, we're excited about how well the consolidated government is working so far, and we'll certainly try to support that in any way we can.
All right, and you have a new job this year heading up to the Capitol. You were appointed a floor leader.
Floor leader by the to help the governor get some legislation through the House, and so that's a big responsibility. I'm looking forward, very honored to be asked to do that. So looking forward to that good challenge, and it'll be a lot of things going on this year with that.
And what about, to backtrack a little bit, we were talking about that rural health care. I know several other Middle Georgia lawmakers have talked about that's going to be a topic. Why is it so important?
Well, I think whether it's large hospitals or rural small hospitals, it's health care is a real challenge these days with funding. And I'm really excited what's going on with the Medical Center Navistar here in Macon. But there's challenges there, but our small rural hospitals such as Forsyth Hospital, Monroe County Hospital, and many others in the media area are really struggling, and we've got to make some issues where we can let them survive and try to carry on for our rural members.
And of course, the Representative Peek's medical marijuana bill will definitely be a topic of discussion this year.
It will. He's invested a lot of time and effort in it, and a lot of research. I'm very much supportive of it. I think it's something we need for our people who have medical conditions to be able availability of that drug. So, hopefully, we'll get that out of the way soon, and it will go through. So.
Anything else you wish to add before you head up to the Capitol, to the Gold Dome?
No, it'll be a long session, a lot of issues, looking forward to it, a lot of opportunities this year. Our economy in Georgia is doing better. I'm very optimistic about state revenues, and I think it'll be a very productive session.
Tonight on the news on 41 NBC at 6, we'll hear from State Representative James Beverly and the possibility of adding Payne City to the Macon BIB consolidated government.
That would be interesting.
It will
kind of incorporate them into everything. That would be cool.